Greetings. It has been hard to organize my thinking for this video. There are so many threads in the world, in the fabric of what is happening in the last days. Years ago, my wife and I realized we needed to learn more direct communication. It took many arguments and many discussions to identify just how critical clear communication was. Both of us realized we each made assumptions of the other. I once said at a dinner with friends, "My wife likes her food cold." She replied, "I do not. What makes you think so?" "The minute our food is served, dear, you start to talk, and you talk until your food is cold." Eventually, our discussion revealed she simply values the conversation more than the food being hot. I, on the other hand, jokingly consider it a noble sacrifice to God to give him a time of prayer and thanks after the food is served, as my food tauntingly wanders toward room temperature. But clearer communication was actually a remarkable turning point in our marriage. In counseling books, there is a mechanism, an approach, called mirroring. One party, listening, has to echo back statements made by the speaker. They are supposed to repeat exactly, without paraphrasing or changing the sentiment. In fact, the changes we introduce, mirroring back, seem to reflect what we thought we heard and what we wanted to hear. It is useful in learning to communicate directly. Because if the hearer has not heard and understood the idea you wish to communicate, you may not be making the progress you hope to be making. Your idea has not successfully been transmitted. So what has this to do with the strong delusion? Delusion, a fixed false belief that is resistant to reason or confrontation with actual fact. The strength of the delusion is the resistance to confrontation with actual facts. The confrontation requires the facts be presented in an understandable way, so they may be understood by the one in bondage to the delusion. And what has this to do with the strong delusion? Communication is transforming into what I now call carnival mirroring. A twisted, distorted misrepresentation of ideas, facts, and information so that actual communication is becoming impossible. A man has recently come to prominence in the confused domain of leftist political correctness. His name is Jordan Peterson, and he has shined the light of logic on leftist political correctness. Initially, the issue related to the gender pronoun insanity. He, she, and it no longer satisfy the confused. Recently, he was interviewed by Kathy Newman of British Channel 4. I watched it and sat amazed at the blatant agenda of this entertainer, Newman. It was the most perfect, twisted example of leftist misrepresentation imaginable. Carnival mirroring at its most evident for all to see. Over and over, she attempted to put words, straw man garbage, into Mr. Peterson's mouth. There is a key phrase which you just have to learn to mock. "So what you're saying is, so you're saying," and I mean mock with the savagery Richard Dawkins calls for against Christians. Newman: "Do you like cats?" Peterson: "I think cats show an interesting independence." Newman: "So you're saying dogs are dependent?" Peterson: "No, I'm not saying anything about dogs." Newman: "So you're saying there is nothing good to say about dogs?" Peterson: "No, I'm only making a statement about cats." That was not an actual extract from the interview, but I think it accurately reflects the carnival mirroring employed by this leftist politically correct talking head. And I think she would deny being leftist because she cannot even see her biased position. It is not the focus of this video, but the secular struggle in the world can be boiled down to this. Individuals versus the state, the mob, the collective. Newman, so you're saying the 50 states are involved with organized crime? Texas, try to listen, Kathy. Where was I? Yeah, right. Meet the strong delusion. This is the nature of the strong delusion that is being poured out in the earth. Those who have rejected the truth are losing the ability to even hear the truth. 2 Thessalonians 2:9. The coming of the lawless one will be accompanied by the working of Satan, with every kind of power, sign, and false wonder, and with every wicked deception directed against those who are perishing, because they refused the love of the truth that would have saved them. The secular world now has a phrase, post-truth. They are trying to convince themselves that, just like they think they have killed God, they have now eliminated any standard of truth. Sadly for them, reality always wins in the end. And with every wicked deception directed against those who are perishing, because they refused the love of the truth that would have saved them. Notice, the deceptions are against those who are perishing. Intentional falsehoods they will be too blind to recognize. For this reason, because they rejected the love of the truth, God will send them a powerful delusion so that they will believe the lie. They will be powerless to hear and receive the truth. There are so many areas today that are demonstrating this mental retardation in the leftist, statist, progressive liberals. If you're a liberal, you've just been offended. The truth will be offensive, brother. In order that judgment or condemnation will come upon all who have disbelieved the truth and delighted in wickedness. The King James says they might be damned who did not believe the truth. Rejecting the truth opens the door wide open for every kind of damnable lie, error, falsehood, and deception. Other areas blindly speeding toward destruction include the now acceptable racism against white people. This is not a movie review against the Black Panther, but think about the political agenda of the film. A black supernation hidden and uncolonized by whites, becoming the greatest technology powerhouse on earth. It's a fantasy, of course, as are all superhero tales, masking the reality one hopes for. Can you think of a nation that was uncolonized, separated and hidden and protected, which became the technological superpower of the planet? America. Protected by oceans on both sides. The white European powers tried to colonize us, but failed. Was it somehow okay because it was white Europeans seeking to dominate other white people? Step back and take a deep breath, and you might realize one human tribe has always tried to dominate another tribe. The Persians, now Iranians, tried to dominate the Greeks. Newman, so you're saying Obama's nuke deal with Iran caused all this? The Japanese tried to enslave the Koreans around World War II. So you're saying Buddhism is at fault for American slavery? The Vikings were raiders over the Europeans. So you're saying NFL teams should be merged instead of a new one in Las Vegas? The Egyptians under the pharaohs conquered and enslaved. Columbus found islands of cannibals who raided, enslaved, and ate those from other Caribbean islands. So you're saying cannibalism is wrong between consenting adults? The list is as long as human history. One strong delusion is that Antifa cannot see they are the fascists. Ever noticed Antifa, sounds a lot like Palace-Hoovian Antifa, duh. I do not think the coincidence is accidental. The social justice racists cannot see they are the racists. Another strong delusion is that sex and gender are fluid but predetermined. Yeah, the strong delusion includes homosexuality being hardwired from the womb, but boys the age of 4 can decide they want to be a girl, then later have regrets and want to change back from Caitlin to Bruce. The insanity is only going to get more violent from here. The world has no hope, because the outcome of this path is predictable and planned. The globalist statist leftists want to slaughter 6 billion human beings. God wants to finish his plan and save all who love the truth. The former cannot grasp they are implementing the plan of the latter. The world has no hope, but people, individuals made in the image of God, have one hope: accepting the salvation, the free gift that God our Creator has offered to each and every individual on earth. Race, sex, nationality, criminal record, sexual misbehaviors do not matter to his free gift. What seems to matter is an honest, real desire for and love of the truth. John 3:16, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him. Whoever believes in him is not condemned, but whoever does not believe has already been condemned, because he has not believed in the name of God's one and only Son. They have not received, accepted, the love of the truth. And this is the verdict, or judgment: the light has come into the world, but men loved the darkness rather than the light, because their deeds were evil." They have rejected the love of the truth because of what it requires. Everyone who does evil hates the light and does not come into the light for fear that his deeds will be exposed. They hide their emails on private servers they think they can wipe and destroy. But whoever practices the truth comes into the light, so that it may be seen clearly that what he has done has been accomplished in God. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.